Hello guys, how are you today? I really hope you liked the last videos where I explained the top 3 KPIs to convert your company into a customer-centric one. So far, I've described the concepts of customer lifetime value and customer satisfaction, CSAT. Today, I will complete the perfect triangle talking about customer churn. Customer churn or churn rate is a crucial KPI to determine the quality of your product, service, and experience. Low churn levels indicate that you are very good at cultivating your clients, and therefore you can expect not to lose them in the near future. This metric is very important for high growth companies, as the average growth rate is often calculated as growth minus churn. Therefore, generally, churn determines the real growth rate of a company. But what is customer churn? It is the number or percentage of customers who stopped using and consequently buying the products or services from your brand for a certain period of time. It is quite simple. You can measure it by dividing the number of customers you lost during, let's say, the last month by the number of customers you had at the beginning of that month. Let me share an example. At the beginning of October, you had 150 customers, but at the end of the month, you only had 132 customers left. This means that you lost 18 customers in October, which equals to 12% of the 150 customers that you had at the beginning of that period. 12% is your churn rate. It is sometimes expressed in monetary value, representing the amount of revenue that you lost due to the loss of your customers. So it's either a percentage or a number. Churn rate is an essential KPI. We all know how hard it is to get new customers, and by paying attention to churn, we could find smart ways to retain them instead of losing them. So how to reduce churn? There is no fast answer. However, I will try to share a couple of tips with you. First of all, proactively reach out to your customers to know more about their experience. If they are dissatisfied and they are planning to leave, in most cases, trust me, they will tell you. It seems too simple to be true, but I tell you, brands hardly show interest in talking to customers. So do not be surprised if this is not happening yet in your company. Second, analyze the trend of your churn rate to detect anomalies or even changes, just simple changes in the trend, but as soon as they happen. In today's volatile markets, a small defect of your product can determine the loss of many customers in favor of your competitors. You want to keep an eye on this and react before it's too late. Speed, timing is crucial now. Third, create an engagement plan that keeps your customers excited. If you sell a software, you could create a course where the users can learn more about the industry, study the best practices, or you could, for example, organize webinars. Generally, creating educational materials and trying to create a community around your product is the best way to increase loyalty. These were just 3 quick tips based on my experience. Let me know your opinion by leaving a comment below. Subscribe to our channel, and for now, thank you so much for watching and see you soon.